Hi, my name is Patrick. With the cat forms Zat, Snap, and Mat, all the forms being out, now how to decide which B schools to apply the next stage? So once you apply for the exams, the next stage is to apply for the colleges. Now you can't blindly accept for apply for colleges. Okay, you apply for cat, you're applying to almost all the IIMs. But what about the other colleges? You need to decide on the B schools that you need to apply. So this video is regarding that. So what parameters you look at it? So I've been training students for the last 20 years, so fairly comfortable with the exams. We train people for management entrance preparation. We're experts in that. We're coming to B schools. There are many B schools. I mean, you count and there are new B schools, etc. Many, many B schools which are there. But you can't apply to everyone. There's a cost involved in applying to colleges. And if you keep on applying to every college, I mean, the cost is huge. So automatically we need to be selective in terms of application to colleges. So how do you apply? I'm looking at parameters on which you should apply. First is based on your mock scores. So try to calculate what is the approximate percentile that you'll score. Okay. So that means if you're scoring, suppose you're scoring some marks, 40 marks. So look at what is 40 marks in the last year's paper, similar paper. What was the percentile? Now obviously, when you prepare by the month of November, you will tend to improve your scores. So see how much you can improve in terms of percentile, tentative. So that will give you approximate percentile that you expected to score. Now, apply to colleges with cutoff around your percentile. You can apply to a couple of colleges with higher percentiles and couple of colleges with lower percentile. I mean, if you're okay with that as a backup colleges. Because what if you score really high? It should not happen that you score high and you're not applied to colleges. What if you score low? But normally what happens for lower percentiles, the colleges, their application forms are open even after the CAT exam. So you don't have to worry about it. So right now only focus on those colleges whose forms are available. Okay, in terms of like SPJ and whose forms are available before the CAT exam and not available after the CAT, MDI Gurgaon, SPN, etc. So look at those colleges and decide whether you want to apply to those colleges or not. Second is based on the area of specialization. So you want to do marketing, so you can think of colleges which are good at marketing. Similarly, if you want to do finance, so there are specific colleges which are good in specific areas. You can look at those. For example, NITI is supposed to be good in operations. So if you're looking at operations, NITI would be one of your best bet. So identify areas where you want to specialize in, okay, that you want to specialize. Shortlist the colleges that are good in those specialization. This is assuming that you know the specialization. If you don't know, it's perfectly all right. You can skip this area. But if you know, then look at the colleges which are good at that specialization and accordingly apply. Next is based on the profile offered. So you want to get into digital marketing or you want to get into investment banking. So identify the profile you want to work in. Okay, digital marketing, equity research, investment banking, whichever profile that you want. Find a company that offer that profile and then look at which colleges the companies visit for campus placement. So that will also help you to, you know, apply to those campuses. If you're very clear in terms of the profile that you want, for example, if I'm looking at digital marketing, I will look at MICA. MICA is supposed to be one of the best colleges for digital marketing. No, good, it's coming up. Similarly, if you're looking at maybe investment banking, I'll look at only your top colleges and try to work on that because investment banking companies come in top colleges. So accordingly, I can then scout for colleges where I can apply to. Also, a lot of students want some average package. I'm already working, I'm already drawing so much of package. I obviously want higher package than that. So what is the expected package post MBA? Okay, then look at the colleges that offer that package or more and accordingly apply. So that is based on average package, specifically people who are already working or who have a job offer at a particular package. Would obviously want a package which is more than that. Look at that. You can also base on any other constraint. It could be location. For example, I want to be only in Mumbai for whatever reason, or fees are very high, I can't afford the extra fees. So all that is a perfect constraint. Look at the constraints that you have and accordingly you can decide on the colleges that you want to apply to. So just given you a few parameters on which you can decide on the colleges. Obviously, you have to do a little bit research on the colleges based on these constraints and then accordingly work on that. Right? I hope this is clear. Thank you.